Which claims?
Do you remember this 1 year ago, this video? I was just showing.
No, give me the claim and what is it?
Sorry, I forgot. I can't remember word by word, but like example this one. Do you remember this time?
Okay. So what is
you destroyed your claim. It's about
what
you
is
mentioned
the claim I am making?
About the Quran.
No.
Well, I've got to watch it again, sorry.
So I have.
I forgot, it's been a while.
Okay,
I just
if you're coming back next week, so
maybe
this,
it's every the claim.
That guy called Idris Ahmed. And Idris Ahmed, I talked about the Allah prays for Muhammad. So I think Idris Ahmed and Muhammad Hijab and Quran would agree with me. Allah does pray for Muhammad.
Praise.
You are such a dishonest being dishonest. But anyway, I'm just gonna give that to you because you haven't probably even bothered to watch the video, you just listen. So Idris Ahmed would agree with me, agree with Muhammad Hijab, and agree with Quran that yes, Allah does pray. P-R-A-Y for Muhammad. Let me finish. And they disagree with me, okay? Who is the he of Allah's prayer? So that is the problem, okay? So we don't have any problem with Allah to pray. The problem is, who is Allah praying to? So, do you have an answer? According to Surah 33 verse 56, Allah does pray with the angels for Muhammad. Do you have an answer that who does Allah pray to?
Well, did you just say that Muhammad Hijab agreed to the fact that Allah prays?
Yeah, in
which video? Where did you see this?
In the public video, he told in the public platform today he took.
Yeah, there was is that the one? The one with the million views, basically.
I don't know the number of the views, but I know Muhammad Hijab is making money
when
from that.
Debate.
I am not talking about that. I'm talking about the part where he turned to David Wood and then he said Allah prays for Muhammad, not to Muhammad. So we all agree that your God prays. Okay? So he is praying for self-confidence. He is praying for self-control. He is praying for guiding the straight path. My question is, please bring me the reference where I am debunked regarding who is the hero of Allah's prayer.
The video shows it all, to be honest, yeah.
Bring the video. But the thing is, it clears to me that you didn't even watch the video.
No, I did. It's been
I look at you without glasses, okay? And with glasses, nobody's my glasses has numbers. And I can see you are younger than me.
Okay.
Therefore, I have high expectations for people who will represent our future. And I am very much disappointed. The video you just show it to me, you don't even know what is the conversation in that video. And you are not even aware one of your Islamic Dawa gang set speakers corner confirmed publicly that Allah does pray for Muhammad. So that's the first thing. Second point. I would love you to also point out for me other claims I make, such as these days I am hanging out with Yasir Kadir. He tells us the narrative account of the Quran when it comes to the preservation, Qirat and Aruz, it has holes in it. Look, even Muslim knows about it. So I am asking the question, if it is all messed up, okay, why your Muslims
Yasir
are running
Qadi
away
from Yasir Qadi.
If it is not that,
it's his opinion.
That
doesn't
answer.
Mean it's true.
The reason they are running away is, let me give examples and then I'll let it speak. Muhammad Hijab interviewed Yasir Qadi and then he took half an hour of the video out where Yasir Qadi expressed it's messed up. Yasir Qadi first took shut down the comments of the video. That wasn't enough. Now he took down the video because now he knows he is causing problem in Muslim world by making statements which are historically correct. So
no,
now
incorrect.
My question to you.
Maybe incorrect.
Now if it is wasn't correct, please do provide me reference evidence. Now, please respond to me. Who does Allah pray to? Okay? That I am debunked on that. And then also the false in the Quran.
You know what I think? Because I'm explorer, basically, yeah? Although I'm a Muslim, but I still like to seek knowledge in other religion, other people's point of views and stuff. And the video, okay, you were saying,
let me Allah just, does not pray.
Yeah, Allah doesn't pray.
Allah sends no prayers and blessings upon any of his
believers. Anyway, sorry. The point I was going to make, basically.
So,
all the problems
are you telling,
have,
if, you know what no, if no Muslim is going to say Allah prays, are we trying to say, out of the Quran is not a Muslim, Allah is just a bunch of
it's just your wrong
information
is
shutting down. That's the first point. Yeah, second point.
Your opinion is wrong.
Second point.
Which Islamic university did you study?
Do you even know what
which Islamic university did you go to study?
You don't even know the word.
No, I know. Excuse me.
I've heard. Do you know what surah is?
Where did you study?
No, Bahar.
Where did you study?
No,
can you read
numbers 31?
Can you read numbers 31? Can you read numbers 31 and tell me how old were those virgins? Those 36,000 virgins that were taken captive.
Why is it?
How old were they?
Islam commits suicide.
Is this the one you're talking about? David Wood and Muhammad Hijab. Is this the one?
Actually, Muhammad Hijab answers the question.
Is this the one?
Yeah. Yes.
Allah praise Muhammad.
Is this the video?
Not too much.
No, but he didn't say it.
You're lying.
I've seen this whole debate.
It's a translation thing.
Let's open it.
My speaker's not that good.
Open it. He did say that. And then he, without any shame, thinks he can correct such a mind called David Wood from the 4 to 2. Allah does pray for
Allah pray. Who did Jesus pray to? If Jesus is God, who did he pray to?
Exactly. Why would she have a problem with it anyway if Jesus is praying?
So if Jesus is God, then
I don't have any problem with that.
You guys are mad.
Jesus prays to his Heavenly Father. There is nothing wrong with that. The Bible screams out that Jesus prays for his Heavenly Father. Yet, Islam teaches Allah's one and only.
But throughout
and that
this coronavirus,
only Allah
only goes
prays
to, be on lockdown.
To someone
didn't cure the coronavirus.
With angels, this freaking moment, that's my problem.
You know what, when I was saying I'm exploring basically people's opinion and views, what I have seen most of the time, yeah?
With the Holy Ghost.
All the problems that Muslims... All the problems that Muslims say that Christianity has, example, God doesn't need to pray to any God, basically, yeah? God doesn't need to pray to any God. Everyone needs to pray to God.
Why don't you have a conversation with Mansour?
He's
much more educated than he is.
Wait, yo,
Habibi, tell him to have a conversation with Mansour.
He ran away already.
Yes, that's a prayer time. But anyway.
Yeah. If it's a prayer time, why he's been chit-chatting over there? Why not? We already been.
Just come, who's Mansour?
Do you want to come back to him?
I can't give you the exact. Oh, look, this point here.
I would love to get them because I have not been debunked. All it's done is.
Have you actually seen these videos?
I am the one who is talking in those videos. All it's been done is Muslims intentionally run away and lie. So if I have been debunked, please bring your reference. Still, according to the Quran, Allah, not the according the Quran, according the Quran, according the Muhammad, according the Muhammad hijab. Allah does pray with the angels, not only by himself. He needs a company with the angels for Muhammad.
No, no, no. Abu, next time I see you guys, I'm going to stay here. Adil.
Okay, so you come back next week, have your point.
I'm going to look at these, yeah, the ones I was talking about. But also with Mansoor, you already, I think you've spoken to Mansoor about the Quran not being preserved and stuff. And I think...
Yeah, he said, letter by letter, sound by sound is being preserved.
Yeah, exactly.
I've got the two different Qurans in my bag, and I showed him they're not preserved, sound, letter, dot.
And you know, that's the same problem with Christianity. Christianity has different Bibles.
Is that the same problem? And let me think through.
Yeah.
Sister, when was last time you said, for all, since the death and resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ, when was the last time you said, Bible, dot by dot, letter by letter, sound by sound, word by word, exactly the same all over the world?
No. But how do you know which one is?
The reason we don't say such a thing.
There's some Quran that there's bits being added onto it. So who can tell that all the bits?
Some Qurans being edited.
No, not Quran. I'm talking about Christianity, the Bibles.
No, the Bibles are the same.
There's some Bible.
It doesn't work like that. The reason it doesn't work like that, Allah and Muhammad is very much fall in love with my scripture. If Allah and Muhammad and Islamic tradition is not very much in love by scripture, bring your evidence before you attack my Bible. That's the first thing. As a Christian, I never make such a claim because I know Bible is written by human beings, inspired 40 different people in 40 different locations, written 1,400 years ago. I haven't finished. When it comes to Quran, for 400 years, 1400 years, without any shame, even last year, your so-called Islamic Dawati, who loves to defend Islam, tell humanity, dot by dot, letter by letter, sound by sound, word by word, has been preserved.
Let me say the significance of the point, sorry. In Islam, correct me if I'm wrong, but this book is meant to be preserved.
And it is, yeah.
It's meant to be with Allah. It's meant to testify on the day of judgment about
the one who decides the right citation.
It's meant to testify, yeah, it's good. Yeah? For us, our living word is Jesus as a person. Yeah? Even Muslims will acknowledge that we say he didn't die, but he's with Allah right now. Yeah? Our living word is Jesus, and the Bible tells his whole story. But at the end of it, we rely on Jesus, and the Bible tells us it. It's inspired because it talks about him.
Okay.
So the difference is, we are not reliant on this book. It's very important. It tells us about Jesus, but the one that we have regard to is Jesus. Whereas, if you get rid of the Quran, what do you have?
You've got all the false books, basically. Because they're not being preserved.
If you get rid of the Quran, you don't have anything.
We've got the book, but it doesn't have all the correct teachings to it.
Okay, so you have nothing.
So you have
everything. No, we got...
Your eternity is dependent on the book, but I have here...
I can't do it perfectly. Especially in front of the camera, I'm not going to attempt.
You are not an Arabic speaker.
I can read Arabic. But I'm not going to.
You're not fluent. Okay,
I'm not fluent enough.
Okay, you come. This is part of the Quran. Different than the Quran you are reciting. Are you Sunni Muslim?
No, but is anyone.
Let us get a question. Are you Sunni Muslim?
And what do you mean by that? When you say Sunni Muslim? No, but. I just want to because I follow the Quran and I follow the Prophet Muhammad. If you call that Sunni Muslim, then yes, I would say yes.
Can you pick the label, whatever label you pick? So, which Quran are you reading today in England?
The one that everyone is reading.
I would go with the majority reading, that's the Hafs Quran. This is different from Hafs Quran, okay? And you can even see the name
and
is
this
different.
Let me finish.
Even the name is different, and it has 5,000 variations from the Quran you are reciting. And in some occasions, it does affect your practical Muslim life.
So are you saying this Quran, what's this Quran? Is this the changed one? Or is this the one the majority of the people are reading?
No. The one you are reading is the majority of the one house.
No, is this the one that I'm reading, basically?
This is the Khalid one. Do you recite the Khalid Quran?
I'm not sure.
Probably you don't. You are not even sure which Quran you recite.
I don't look into that much detail into it because there's only one Quran.
Basic.
No, but that's only one Quran. No, but I read the one that everyone reads. Sorry?
I'm holding two different Qurans.
Okay, that's
right
what I'm trying to. Okay, so this one is English translation, is it? Or
no,
Arabic?
This is Arabic.
Full Arabic.
Full Arabic.
Okay, so this, what's this blue thing? This is the different bit. Are you saying? You know this blue hat? Where is? Are you saying this is?
Look where it's been put together.
Okay, but are you saying, okay, so this Quran...
It's been printed in 2009.
Okay, no, okay, but this one, this Quran is different to this Quran, are you saying?
This Quran is different to
the Arabic.
So which Quran is this one?
This is the Hafs. That's the probably you are reciting.
Okay, so you got the...
Which mosque do you go to?
Huh?
Which mosque do you go to?
I'm not even from here, to be honest, but Southwest London,
if you
Mosque,
go to, if you go to
Regent
Park
Mosque, for example, yeah.
So you are reciting this one?
Yeah, this okay. is the study.
So, why are you not reciting this one? Or why this one is different in 5,000 places from this one?
This is the first time I'm seeing you telling
so
me...
So, how come this is the first time you are saying why you came approach my sister that my arguments are debunked? Because I've been using the arguments of 26 different Arabic Qurans or 37 different Arabic Qurans for a couple of years.
No, I'm just saying this is the first time I've seen two different Qurans in front of me and you're asking these questions in detail. I'm not the person to know these stuff in detail.
But that's basic. As I said, I'm not asking you to like put together the quantum physics for me. I'm asking you that you said, if she asked you the question, if you get rid of the Quran, what will you end up? You said nothing. So your return is based on this book. And there is nothing else. Yeah, sorry, this book. And there is nothing else out there. And you see, you don't even know one to one of your. That's like basic. But Islam one to one basic.
No, but everyone that's a Muslim, they know that they follow this one Quran, basically.
No, that's not true. According to Sheikh Yasir Qadir, and even let me show you actually what Sister Juma.
And you know, one thing, sorry, but I like the fact that, you know, the fact that you two both said inspired, Bible's inspired, where the Quran itself claims that it's the word of God, basically. Where the Quran, the Bible doesn't claim that it is the word of God.
So where does Quran say it is the word of God?
It is, it says it in there.
Right.
I'll show you somewhere.
Please,
I'll try and see if I can find it, but I've definitely seen that claim. Like,
I don't want to be the heartbreak victim here, but sometimes it's okay to have a broken heart, okay? So this is the book. It's coming. It's gonna come. It's coming today, okay? So recently, part of Dawa people, okay, Muslim missionaries, put together a book, okay? The book is titled, wait, oh, come on. So book is titled The Richest Translation of the 10 Qur'an of the Noble Quran by Fadal Suleyman. Okay? A Muslim is simply translating the different Arabic Qurans to English. He is only translating 30 different Arabic Qurans to English, and in here he's got a huge table. It's coming. It's coming, it's on its way. Here's the list of the 30 different Arabic Qurans, okay? And then he translates those 30 different Arabic Qurans in here, page by verse by verse, okay? So you've got the Arabic here, in here you've got the English, and then at the bottom you've got the footnotes, okay, tells you Nafi's Quran and Abu Jafar's Quran is different when it comes to this verse. It's not only different in Arabic, but even when you translate it to English, it is different. And in here, you've got minimum of 4,000 variations And also, that is only 30% of the different ones, okay? And this was put together by a Muslim. So do check it. Do check it. And when you come back next week, hopefully it will be next week, and then debunk me. So yeah, if you definitely debunk me, I am here every week, and I never come to Quran speak a sermon with my running shoes, okay?
So, Reshi's not saying this to give you a hard time. It's because we generally believe that
Jesus is the way, but not the final destination. As you may have heard that a lot of times.
One of the things I do agree about.
Because I follow,
one of the things I do agree about the Quran is Surah 19:19, where it describes Jesus as a pure soul. It calls him Messiah. It says he has no father except for Allah. It calls him the Word. It calls him the Spirit of Allah. These things I can agree. And there's something special about Jesus. So we're not coming here just to upset people.
No.
Okay, yeah, you hear us, yeah? If there's a God, he's given us all this knowledge, yeah? He wants us to take it seriously, because when you go to heaven and you stand before him, your Imam is not going to be there, your Muslim brothers are not going to be there, your scholars are not going to be there, and it's going to be, did you take the information that Hatun has given you today seriously?
No, of course. I know where you're coming from.
Yeah, okay,
good. I am here every week, and I am ready to be debunked. But if you cannot debunk me, that doesn't mean you go out and then do false teaching so that people come and attack you. There is no reason
No.
If you cannot debunk me, you can simply say, it is the topic, I'm not comfortable about it, and I know it affects my eternity, but I don't want to talk about it because I'm not ready yet. That's absolutely fine.
No, of course. Like I said, I'm always exploring, yeah? I'm always wanting to learn more and understand more about these religion and people's views. But one thing that is a bit contradicting in Christianity views, yeah? What you just said about Jesus, example. So if he's, do you believe that he's a prophet? Because if you do, then how can you say... How can he be God as well, though? He's a prophet. How can God be a prophet?
I think understand your look, because you're asking very good questions. These are important questions, but you have no background in Torah, nor what the prophet said.
Maybe does he have
that? No, just generally.
Maybe you do
have that.
Sorry.
Let's do the very basics.
Yeah, easy questions. Like, how can one thing be two different things?
That's very easy. For example, what are the things you need to put together Tawhid? Tawhid is the oneness of Allah. What kind of things you need to put to make Tawhid?
What are the characters?
Just nothing, just one God. You just need one God and that's it.
I would say, even according to Islam, that's not true. So for you to put the Tawhid together, I'm going to answer your question on Jesus. I just want to give you an illustration. For you to put the Tawhid together, you need Allah, okay? You need Jesus, because Islamic Jesus shares the attributes of Allah, and he creates. You need the Spirit of Allah, okay? Spirit of Allah creates. That means shares the attributes of Allah. You need black stone, intercedes for people when you kiss it. Okay? You need the urine of Muhammad. You need the spit of Muhammad. And then it goes on. All these things makes Tawhid. So, there is nothing wrong. And by the way, Tawhid by definition is the unifying things, okay?
Yeah.
So, you are unifying something. What will be my question, but that's you think about it. So, sister, what's your name?
Sarah.
Sir, what's your name?
James.
James, okay? So how many eyes does James have? He's got two eyes, but he's one being. How can he has two eyes? Guys, imagine. She's got how many fingers she has?
She's got two thumbs.
Eight.
I mean eight, sorry.
She's got eight fingers. Yeah. How come she has eight fingers while she's only one being? So there is nothing wrong to see there is one being, yet there is plurality in this being, okay? okay, there is nothing wrong. And that was the same for Israelites in the Torah. If you read the Torah,
I don't think God can be like a human being, though.
Of course, there is nothing like
fingers and eyes and stuff as an example.
I haven't finished. So, one of the things that Christians and Muslims agree is there is nothing like God.
Wait, do you agree with that?
According to Christians, of course, there is nothing like that. Yeah. My brain will never be able to understand how wonderful, delightful, awesome my God is. Scripture says, with His word, with the power of His word, He holds all universe together. My brain will never be able to understand that, and there is no one else can do that. So, while that takes place, we come to the scripture. Scripture screams out there is one God, okay? Help me understand. Do you think James looks like he's got six packs, he's tall? Do you think he can give eternal life? No. If James is a doctor, can James give eternal life? Only God can. Can Muhammad give eternal life? Can any prophet give eternal life? Only God can.
Eternal, like as living forever.
Yeah, living
only
forever,
God lives forever
in a very good quality life. Only God
is perfect.
Can.
Okay. Yeah. God is perfect.
Yeah. He's perfect, he's satisfied, he doesn't need anything, and he's the one who gives eternal life. So now, this is the time we will see how good your knowledge of the previous scripture. Please turn with me to John chapter 10.
Okay. What do you mean? Join me.
Turn with me. Where is the John chapter 10 in your...
I don't do it like that. Sorry.
You don't do it?
No. I'm just here to listen, basically.
So, you already told me it is only God who gives eternal life.
No, it doesn't give. No, only God is eternal, that's it. He doesn't give to anyone else.
Oh, really?
Like, as in, how can He give eternal life to someone else? Because He is...
So God is eternal. So when, let's say, Muhammad died, and then when he gets to paradise, is Muhammad going to have only certain amount of time of in paradise, or Muhammad is going to live in paradise forever?
No, hang on. Sorry, before I answer that. Let's just see if you understand this as well. So you're saying, you know how we say, oh, God is like no one else, like how we can imagine.
I strongly agree God is eternal. I am asking. I ask, can James give eternal life? You said no. And then you said it's only God who can give eternal life.
I didn't mean to say that. If I did, sorry about that. Because it's like saying but to me, what it seems like, yeah. If God is perfect example, God is like, you know, ever living, basically, can God give that to someone else? Example, can God make another God?
No, that's not the question.
I'm asking you that because I think that's what you're trying to apply.
Can God make another God? No, I'm not trying to apply that. I am Christian. Why would I ask such a question?
My question is, listen, that's what it seems like.
God is eternal. He doesn't have beginning. He doesn't have.
And can he make someone else like that as well? Sorry.
No, I'm not asking that.
I'm asking because you believe Jesus is like that.
No, I'm saying, how can...
Sorry. But do you see my question though? Like, do you see my point?
Because you're starting in a funny place. So let her explain. Let me first handle
the first question you asked, and then I will handle the second question you are asking. Okay? So, the video, when Sarah dies, okay, are you capable to make the Sarah to live forever in a perfect conditional of life?
Okay, so I see your point. Yes, so God can. Yes, so after she has died, she will live on forever. Yes, she's risen. She will live forever, basically, and everyone else. Okay.
Can you do that to her?
Only God can.
Only God. Okay. Can Muhammad do that?
No, only God can.
Can James do that?
Jesus can't as well.
Can James do that?
No one can.
Can NHS do that?
No.
Can Cambridge Research Faculty do that? No. It's only God does.
Yes.
Okay.
But not Jesus.
No, of course, not Jesus, only God. Yeah. Okay. Jesus answered. I tell you the truth,
but you do not believe.
The miracles I do in my Father's name speaks for me, but you do not believe because you are not my sheep. My sheep listen to my voice. People who believe in Jesus, okay, will listen to the voice of Jesus. Today, since 33 AD, death and resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ, there are billions, billions, billions believers of Jesus. And Jesus says, they listen to my voice. His voice is so powerful. Only not people listen to his voice. I know them and they will follow me. When I hear his voice, I will be following him, his voice, okay? He doesn't only stop there, he says, I give them eternal life. So if only God gives eternal life, Sarah can't give it, James can't give it, you can't give it, for sure I can't give it. Jesus says, he's the like sinless prophet of Islam, okay? Sinless prophet of Islam says, I give them eternal life, not only eternal life, but even when people hear his voice, they will obey that. For that, for even people Jesus to know, who heard his voice. Jesus must be all-knowing, all-powerful and all-present. Jesus must know from 33 AD to 2020 how many believers he had. And he must able to keep them, and it not only.
So are you saying that Jesus? So Jesus is saying so far.
It didn't finish that.
But so far is Jesus saying that I only give eternal life.
Jesus says I give them eternal life, and they shall never perish. No one can snatch them out of my hand. Even his hand is so powerful.
Can you tell me who is Jesus?
Listen, get on the line. Listen, you are number six.
Okay, who's Jesus?
Even his voice is so powerful. He's so powerful. No one. Not Muhammad, not James, not Sarah can take anyone from the hand of Jesus.
Can I have a look? If
Jesus is giving such eternal life, okay, can you please be kind and gentle to me and explain to me?
No, who is Jesus?
Why can you say it is only God? Get on the line, you are number six. I told you, get on the line.
Who Jesus is?
Jesus is the one who only gives eternal life, and you said
if he gives eternal life, why did he die?
So that you can have
he
eternal life.
He couldn't save his own ass. How did he die?
He gave himself for humanity. No, that's a lie. I already have.
She's answered.
Because listen, she said Jesus from 33 AD until 2019. 33 AD until 2019.
Yeah.
The Bible doesn't go back as far as 70 AD. So what about what happened between 30 AD and 70 AD? Because the Bible she's reading from doesn't go back to 33 AD. What happened between 33 and 70? Ask that question.
You can answer it if you want. I'm just here to just understand everyone, basically. So no, if you can explain more if you want to. But
so what is the question?
The question is, sorry. So are you trying to say basically that Jesus has been given eternal life?
Jesus claims that he gives eternal life to James, to this lady, to this gentleman, to everyone who believes in him.
Jesus is God. What God can do, Jesus can do, because Jesus is God, according to her. So what she's saying, according to her, from a Christian standpoint, makes sense. Okay?
From Christian.
But does it make sense to you?
No, it doesn't, of course. I've already said.
So the question is, why do you believe Jesus is God? If Jesus can give it eternal life, why do you believe Jesus is God? That's the question to ask. Get to the root of the matter and see what her response is.
Please kill other people's question, and then you can come back next week and then you can say, you were debunked. Let me rephrase my question to you. Are you saying that
he's going to do this on the day of judgment, or are you saying that
it's not what I'm saying. It is what the scripture is saying.
No, but when is that applying to? When is that applying
to? Jesus is talking to the Jews, and he says, I give them eternal life. Jesus doesn't say.
No, it says through the Father, though. No, but if
where does it say through the Father?
Before you said people that in my name, you know. Look, when you started to read it, where did you start reading it from? From here, yeah? Because you said they do miracles in their name, in the Father's name. Is there no word with Father written here?
Did you listen what I read?
Yeah.
You said,
I read it again. Okay. Jesus answered. Jesus is talking to the Jews.
Bro, these guys are trolls. Don't waste your time. I promise.
Speak.
No, I'm just listening.
Tell me.
Speak.
They're trolls.
It's absolutely fine.
If you have a question, ask her the question. If there's something that you believe, which she believes, and they're different, ask the question.
No, you can ask.
The proof is, look, she's making claims, so the proof is on her to justify her claims to you. So think logically and think from your background and your ask the question.
Okay, let's just hear it again. Okay, can you just say what you were going to say?
So I am not a broken record to repeat it again. I will read it again and then we've done, okay? And if you want to cheat the questions from this gentleman and follow this gentleman and not talk to me, that's absolutely fine.
No.
But you are accountable for this conversation on the Day of Judgment. Jesus is speaking to the Jews, okay? Unbelieving Jews. Jesus answered, I did tell you, but you do not believe. The miracles I do in my Father's name speak for me, but you do not believe because you are not my sheep. In here, in the context of you are not the people who believe in me. My sheep listen to my voice. So this is the language which has been used in the Old Testament. God is shepherd to his people. My sheep listen to my voice. I know them. So people who have been following God, okay, they know his voice, they follow him, they obey him. And so this is kind of last days of Jesus, okay? Last days of Jesus, 33 AD up to today. Jesus is saying, believers, okay, believers like me today, he knows who I am, okay? His voice is able to make me to obey him. That's already tells me Jesus is all powerful, all present,
and all knowing.
So,
my sheep listen to my voice.
Yeah,
I know them.
That my people, like his followers, like as in, Jesus' followers.
I am followers of Jesus. So Jesus knows who I am. So Jesus is all knowing, all powerful, and all present.
He doesn't know who you are. He knows the people that are there.
I know them, and they follow me. I give them eternal life. And they shall never perish. No one can snatch them out of my
and you know the starting bit when you said you know when you read it again, it says he does it in the name of Father. Basically.
The miracle side though, they speak of my Father.
So the Father has the control. Basically.
Yes.
Because when he was resurrected as well, who resurrected Jesus?
God resurrected himself.
He even resurrected.
I will raise up this temple in 3 days. I will raise up.
Tell me the Father.
It's the triune God.
Dead. How
because
can
he's
do
dead.
Anything?
Exactly.
He's dead.
But Jesus is not dead.
The flesh is dead. Even if he's saying,
what logic?
You're telling me he's God.
Jesus,
and
Jesus, So Jesus died, and on the third day he resurrected. Okay, it is triune God fully involved his resurrection. And in John account, Jesus says, I will build this temple again in 3 days. Jesus himself is actively involved. His resurrection. Huh? But my question to you is, if it is only God who gives eternal life, and Jesus says I give eternal life, what does that make Jesus according to Scripture?
To the Scripture, what I understand, he's saying he does things from the power of the Father, basically. So if the Father allows it, example, to, you know, when he did miracles, I believe in Jesus that did miracles.
It doesn't say I am doing these miracles because Father is giving me permission. Does it say that? Read it with me. I did tell you, but you do not believe. The miracles I do in my Father's name speak for me. It doesn't say, Father, give me the permission to do that. That's not my question. Even though if that is the case, it doesn't say, my question was to you, you said, it is only God who gives eternal life. Jesus gives eternal life. What does that make Jesus? You don't need to answer that.
No, of course. I see your point. And one more thing I see a bit different in Christianity,
Just answer this question and then we move on. sorry, you okay, make sorry. An argument. So, you say it is only God gives eternal life. But, if this scripture is correct, Jesus gives eternal life. But, Jesus claims to be God, yes or no?
No, according
here, it's not like you believe
but your understanding is different though, is what I'm saying. Okay, fair enough, you might have a point. But
it's
I'm just
not,
saying.
It's not, so, do you believe? Okay, did you not tell me it is only God who gives eternal life? It's only did God, you not
yes,
tell?
Yes.
So, and now, according to this book, Jesus says, I give eternal life. Then I ask the question, if only God gives eternal life, and Jesus says, I give eternal life, what does that make Jesus? God. That makes Jesus God. You agree? You accept or not, but that's what the scripture is saying.
Fair enough. Okay.
Okay? So, if you disagree with that, what is your option B of the interpretation of this scripture?
Because I've seen so many other places.
No, I'm not talking about Bible. So many other places. Just this tell one, me this one.
This one, and my understanding is different. No, but like I said, my understanding is different.
So your understanding is different because you don't believe anymore in everyone. It is. You don't believe anymore that it is only God who gives eternal life.
No, I do believe
so
only God.
So you still believe it is only God gives eternal life. And Jesus says, I give eternal life. Like one-to-one maths that make Jesus God, but you have a problem.
When is Jesus giving eternal life?
I think all prophets are able to give eternal life. But
did Muhammad give eternal life?
No, just a minute. Let me finish this.
Not all the prophets. I am asking you to back up. Did Muhammad give eternal life?
Within the Creator's power. Because if you follow all the words in Christianity you've got the 12 if you obeyed all the laws and you were practicing all the teaching of your prophet, then you will be granted an eternal life.
Okay, let me debunk that once for all. So Jesus is speaking in here. Jesus doesn't say law is going to give you eternal life. Jesus doesn't say. Jesus says, I give you eternal life. Jesus says, I give you eternal life. Not the law. And basic things people always forget about Christianity is, it doesn't matter how much I do. It doesn't matter how best I do. It is God's kindness towards me. I am given eternal life because the death and resurrection of Lord Jesus Christ. He gave me eternal life. Sir, I take the next. We see you next week. See you next week. See you next week. And that's the scripture. If God is the only one who gives eternal life and Jesus says, I give eternal life, that makes Jesus God. Therefore, I want to gently remind you that as Jesus gives eternal life to those who believe in him, he does that with his death and his resurrection on the cross. And that eternal life is having fellowship with God himself. Therefore, all I can do is, I can say, before it is too late, respond the kindness God is showing to you. God is screaming out to you, I love you, I want you to be mine, would you be his?
I think I'm done, sir.